Okay, so that was Bolero by Maurice Ravel, French composer. The story goes that Ravel wrote this on a napkin, the percussion part for this piece, which goes through the entire piece of music. And we did a little Google research, and what did we find, Catherine?
But that's not true.
It's not true. It's an internet hoax. Okay, so now that we've disproven that, let's talk about the B-flat clarinet solo in Ravel's Bolero. There is also an E-flat clarinet solo, which is equally, if not more famous than that, but we're going to talk about this solo. First thing I'm going to talk about, I'm actually talking about two things. First thing I'm going to talk about is, why am I sitting cross-legged? Let me tell you. You know, there is a crutch. A lot of the time when people play clarinet, they rest their clarinet between their knees. Now, if they actually put them in between their knees, it makes your low B, which comes, you play a lot of Bs in this, that note, it makes it really flat when it's stuck between your legs. Listen. So it's a habit that some people get where they rest the clarinet between their legs, and when they play that B, the B is really flat. Well, you can't do that when you have your legs crossed. So it's a great way to check yourself to make sure you're playing with the clarinet sort of without anything to hold it, and it's great. It's sort of great for your posture, and it's good for making sure that you're not playing that B out of tune because it's between your legs. Okay, so the next thing I want to talk about comes from an email that I got today asking me to play this piece, Bolero, and the question the person asked was, how do you play this smoothly? Well, here's the thing. Bolero, is especially this clarinet solo, the whole thing is supposed to be really suave and smooth. And how do you make something smooth when you have to go between an A and a B as often as you do in this excerpt? Well, fortunately, there's this thing called the right hand down technique. It is not cheating. It is actually how most clarinet players play and how they get smooth technique going between the break. Let me show you what this means. So, Bolero, look at my fingers as I play this. I have to go between the second register, like from D and, you know, C sharp and B to the A really smoothly. That's all in the, you know, in the second register. So when I'm going down from the B to the A, how do I get that smooth? It's called right hand down. Let me show you what that means. When you're playing an A and you're going to a B, or the other way around, you have to move a lot of fingers at once, right? You're going from playing an A, which is using just this finger, to playing a B, which is this finger, plus these two fingers, plus your thumb and your register key, plus these three fingers, plus the B. That's a lot to coordinate. Here. No matter what you do, you're still coordinating two hands where all of the notes have to go down at the same time. All of the holes have to be covered. Everything has to go down at the same time, or you may squeak. So, how do you make this easier? Check this out. When you play an A, you can actually put these three fingers down, or even these three fingers plus one of these keys down. Well, not this one, but you can put one of the three keys down, like the C, the B, or the C sharp key. All of those can go down when you're going between the two registers. Why does that matter? Well, check it out. If I have these down, and I have to go to a B, these fingers are already down. They don't have to move. The only ones that have to move are these two, the thumb and register key, and this going from an A to an F sharp. Now you might think, well, does that change the pitch of the A? A little bit. Listen. It changes it a little bit, but in a good way. See, the A and the G tend to be sharp notes. When you put those fingers down, it actually brings it into tune. So it's a good thing. Then, when you have to go between that A and the B, or the A and the C sharp, it's a heck of a lot easier than going. So when you're playing this excerpt, then that makes going down the break so much smoother. So right hand down technique is not I'm going to look at you when I say this. It is not cheating. I swear to you, it's not cheating. It's a way for you to play more smoothly over the break. Give it a shot. It's really useful in a piece like this, like Bolero, but it's also useful whenever you're going over the break, even if it doesn't have to be smooth. Why do you have to coordinate both of your hands? You don't. So use the right hand down technique and practice with it. You will soon get used to it, and you will love the fact that you just got used to it, okay? Go do it. Give it a shot. See you next time. Bye.